There's no secret. There's no shortcut. Everything that is alive is conscious. Be silent. Be still and know God. Until you feel worthy, it ain't gonna happen. Rigorous, ruthless, disciplined focus. You have to get to a place where you can work on yourself. If you are looking to live at the tip of the spear when it comes to health optimization, join my private membership group, fullyoptimizedhealth.com, and get the latest and greatest on hormone optimization, peptides, fitness, fat loss, and most importantly, raising your vibration. Again, go over to fullyoptimizedhealth.com and sign up today. Well, hello, ladies and gentlemen, wherever you may be around the world. I am Jay Campbell, and of course, you are watching the Jay Campbell Podcast, and I'm very excited today to be joined in my StreamYard virtual studio, all the way live from Austin, Texas, Charles Clay. Charles, what's going on, my brother?
Let's go. Bringing the aloha vibes straight from Hawaii. We just landed back in Texas and incorporating that vacation vibration into our daily lives here. So happy to be here.
That's awesome, man. I'm grateful to have you here. I'll give you guys his bio in a second, but you got the golden Hawaii tan. Now that I notice, it's you got the gold, you got the glow in the cheekbones, the high cheekbones anyway, but you do have the Hawaii tan. Where were you, in all the islands, or were you just like in Maui, or where?
We did a little island hopping. We have some friends in Oahu that run a farm there.
And very cool.
Full Circle Farm. So we spent a lot of time there, and then Kauai, which is one of my favorite islands.
One of the most amazing places in the whole world, bro. Like, you know, what is it? What is the canyon there? Waimea Canyon, the Grand Canyon of the Pacific. Absolutely most spectacular, breathtaking, natural, vistas. Did you guys take a helicopter up in it or just hike through it?
We've done that before. We didn't tackle the Nepali coast hike this time.
Yeah.
I got my little girl. But we got lots of beach time in, and
nice, man.
It's like a downshift of two gears compared to, you know, normal life here.
Back in the matrix, my brother. Yeah, actually, Charles and I were just talking off air, everybody, about like how I just parachuted back into Florida. Many of you guys know that. To be closer to my daughters, but also just there were many reasons. My business is expanding, and it's just hard to get stuff sent to you in Mexico or to deal with people in from a business standpoint. But we were talking about how when you leave the States, it is a massive, like you do downshift. That's probably the best way to say it from a space standpoint, right? Because you just have the ability to not be bothered by the amount of distractions that we have living in the United States, which is unreal. But I'm glad you enjoyed yourself, and I'm glad you're here today. So you guys, let me give you his bio. He is an inner peace coach and a healer. Also a neurokinetic pain relief specialist and creator of the laser focus method and the inner peace process. He offers high level coaching and step-by-step inner peace process for releasing internal blocks, unprocessed emotions, and negative subconscious beliefs that keep people feeling stuck. So he's a perfect guest on the Jay Campbell Podcast. So what I've been doing, Charles, recently, and for the record, today is Thursday, August 10th. And the good news is for you, bro, is because I've been moving the last 3 months, my podcast queue is whittled down to the floor. So you're not going to be, your podcast will run probably actually within a month, which is epic. If not within a month, like literally mid-September. I kind of am just getting my guests, you know, grip really, you know, opinion, viewpoint of like where we are, you know, in the year 2023 and where we're going. I mean, obviously guys like you and I are obviously, you know, half glass full positive mindset people, but like, where do you see the planet going? Like, are you a buyer of planet Earth or a seller?
I would say I'm more of a steward of planet Earth, you know, working in homeostasis as much as possible with nature. And, you know, we're at a pretty exciting crossroads. You know, more and more people are waking up every day and recognizing, you know, the matrix compared to, you know, remembering that we are these epic eternal souls having a human experience in these incredible sensory suits that we get to enjoy for such a short time. And we often forget our own power, you know, our greatest asset, our attention and our energy, because where our attention's going, you know, whether we're complaining about the worst things going on in the world and giving that fuel for that fire, or say thanks for the contrast of showing us what isn't working and what doesn't work well, let's create something better. Right. And so stepping into that creator consciousness, the more people that choose that and begin co-creating more and more, it's already happening. You know, we have the potential for quite the golden age.
Yeah. The golden age is here, right? It's a perception. Mm-hmm. It's a mindset. It's where you place your consciousness. It's everything we see very much eye to eye. And it is interesting, the idea that – I love that answer, you're a steward, because there are many of us that are stewards. And as you know, it's been, you know, rather – I would say the last 3.5 years, rather than label it negative or positive, let's just say it's been interesting, right? if you come from a place of observation, which I know you do and so do I, and it's really just about like leaning into it and figuring out like how can I learn from this, you know – interesting. I don't want more of that, right? I'd love more of this, but everything that happens to us or every choice that we make is an opportunity for learning, right? And obviously from learning, there's growth and advancement. As I always say, we're only here, and I know you agree, just from listening to you, just in the minimal time that I have, we're here for soul advancement, bro. I mean, you know, we come here to evolve and grow the soul, and every experience provides that opportunity, but only when you allow it to provide that opportunity. Because if you label things negatively, if you're not perceptionally looking at everything as an opportunity for growth, then you get stuck, right? And that's what we're probably going to talk about in this podcast, because so many people do. I mean, there's a million different ways to decline it, but that's pretty much what happens. Like, you're either in resistance or you're in flow. And when you're in flow, it's like, acceptance, cool, allowance, give me more.
Right. Absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah. All right, man. So you got a bunch of different talking points, but clearly we're resonant souls. We see a lot of things together, so I may go in different directions. But your first talking point is how to move from pain to purpose, which is literally what I was just saying. So like, give us your talking points and your thoughts on how people can move from pain to purpose.
Yeah, you know, this sensory suit that I talk about, the human body is always giving us messages, right? Always giving us intel, whether we're listening or not. And correct. We've been taught, conditioned, that when something goes wrong, to reach externally for a pill, for, you know, guidance outside of us. But every time we're feeling a sensation, pain, you know, based on the intensity of that pain is how important that message is for you from your body. And pain is, I love the acronym, pay attention inward now. It's an opportunity to go inward and actually, you know, we've just been conditioned to avoid pain, seek pleasure. But if you actually go into it, there's recognizing that pain is energy. And energy is information. So there's some important information that our body wants to share with us. And there's a simple self-inquiry that I offer. There's three questions. Anytime you're dealing with pain, anytime you're getting, you know, life's curveballs, or you're stuck, you're dealing with some challenges, you're in a storm, you can ask yourself these three questions. And, you know, the quality of the questions we ask can greatly enhance the quality of our lives. And that's because instead of going into the negative default programs, which looks like, oh my gosh, my shoulder, it's killing. And we go on Google and we search for, like, you know, find worst case scenarios there. And then it increases the anxiety and fight or flight state. So instead, it's an opportunity to really bring your mind as an instrument for heat-seeking missiles to receiving answers and guidance and insight. And, you know, probably familiar with the reticular activation system. This is a phenomenon. It's always going on with our mind. So we can use that to our advantage just by asking good questions. So the first one is, how is this happening for me? And that's an important one, because it can instantly take us from a victim mindset of, why is this happening to me? Ah, and that just prolongs the experience of suffering much longer than needed. And then we're empowered to take some responsibility, take a look at what's going on, and how is this happening for me? So then you're taking your mind out of the negative default programs and into, let's find some answers to this. Second question, what needs to change? And this is a big one, because, you know, there's something in your lifestyle, in, you know, the way you're showing up or not showing up that, or addictions or vices, these things will get highlighted. These answers will come through either instantaneously or through synchronicities. And then once you receive the answer, it's about honoring that, you know, making that shift in your life to realign. And so the third question is, what are the lessons to learn and the blessings to earn from this experience?
Love that.
And that's a big one because, you know, I think we've all experienced like, man, I thought I healed that. It's like a reoccurring injury or, you know, the abandonment wound or just some frustration that can come up when we think we've healed something, but it shows up again. It can be, you know, pretty devastating, disappointing and frustrating. Yet you're getting to look at it from a different lens this time because you've grown and changed and seen a lot more since that last time it happened. But I find that when you extract, you embody those lessons and blessings from those challenges, then you notice it doesn't have to keep showing up in your life anymore, yeah, you know, in that way, which is beautiful. You know, it's all happening for us. So those are some self-inquiry questions. It's always a great place to start. I would go for that before searching on Google, all this controlled information from screens.
You know? Yeah.
And that's always an opportunity to connect and improve this relationship with your body, with your soul, and then intuition as well, which is, you know, we talk about when we're praying to God, creator, that's when we're, you know, talking to God, when we're listening and honoring our intuition, that's God talking to us.
That's right. That's right.
So we can improve that relationship. And every time you follow your intuition, even if it doesn't make rational sense, and you just say yes to it and reach out to that person or do that thing, there it is. Life just keeps getting better. And it is always improving that relationship with your soul. So
beautiful, man. I mean, I say the same thing, except I don't call it God because so many people have the notion of God as a man sitting on a chalice judging them. But I call it the higher self, but it's the same thing. It's exactly what you're saying. I mean, you cannot be misled or deluded or led down the wrong path if you understand and hear and connect with your higher self, which is your intuition, you know. And I, by the way, I've played that game. You know, I've said this a couple of times on this podcast, but you can absolutely communicate with your higher self, right? Or your intuition, however you want to, you know, rephrase it. Some people call it the divine ego. There's a lot of different names for it, depending on culture. Sages have so many names for it, but like, you can say higher self, is it in my highest and best interest to blank? And it's usually a yes or no question you want to ask, right? And if you're truly connected to your higher self, and obviously we do this like anything else through practice, meditation, introspection, sitting in nature, as you said, listening to the answers, you know, I always tell people, it's like, there's nothing to learn. It's just to remember.
Yep.
Right. That's it. Right. I mean, you get to that level, but for me, I get the hair stand up on the left part of my arm. And then when it's a really serious one, like, hey, MF-er, you better look out because something bad's about to happen, like back of my neck.
Yeah.
So I'm completely connected to that in my life. And it's, I mean, bro, I'm not joking. Like I experience it at least 3 to 4 times a week, right? Luckily, nothing serious recently. But again, like you said, when you listen to your intuition, your inner knowing never mislead you. It's never going to turn you wrong. And I mean, you know, how many times have we thought about in our life when we weren't as aware consciously, or we hadn't remembered as much as we've remembered now, where we didn't listen and we regret, right? And you regret, you know, it's like, God, I knew the answer, but I still didn't listen to myself. And that really comes in slowing down, as you were just saying, all those profound words that you just used. I mean, literally it's just slowing down and being conscious of listening, you know?
And it's important to have some tools to be able to slow down and to calm your nervous system and go from that fight or flight state that is so common these days to a place of your natural state of inner peace and where you can actually listen to that voice and that expression of your intuition. Oftentimes people can't find it over the loud ego and mind chatter because their awareness is up here so much. So that's a lot of what I offer is some powerful tools for just taking a greater reaches down into your heart space, into the intelligence in each and every cell of your being. And there is a lot of answers for you. And this connection allows the mind to be a beautiful instrument of the heart. And then we're always operating from what's in the highest and greatest good for all, you know, and that's a great place for accessing solutions and creating win-win-win scenarios with business meetings. And, you know, being a creator from that space is much different than operating from like, what's in it for me? I got to make this work, get these bills paid and blah, blah, blah. You know, that energy, when we create from that fight or flight state, you're literally perpetuating more, you're calling in more experiences like that, that create more fight or flight. And so when you downshift and, you know, use one of the greatest tools that's right under your nose, your breath, to, you know, slow down your exhale longer than your inhale and just watch as you can calm your nervous system. I have a really simple expansion breath technique I teach that allows people to really access that state. And it's beautiful, because then you're self-sourcing, and every time you're like receiving answers and taking action from that place, you need less externally. Yeah. And what an exciting place to operate from.
Are you currently suffering from a testosterone deficiency? Are you already using therapeutic testosterone? If you are, go to totdecoded.com/10-questions and find out the top 10 questions you need to be asking your doctor about therapeutic testosterone. These are critical questions to ask your doctor. If they can't answer them, you need to find another doctor. Yeah, man. It's awesome. Are you a surfer? I sense that you're a surfer.
Yeah.
I can see it in your shoulders, in your traps.
Absolutely.
I mean, talk about inner peace. Right. I mean, like that's the one place, you know, it's interesting that you were talking about, or what you were just talking about, because I haven't shared this with anyone. Some reading and some very deep meditation afterwards recently. And I'm sure you know this, but very few people do know this. The birds, you know, really all of nature, all the animals and the animal kingdom are, you know, obviously part of the source field. You know, the energy and frequency of everything and nothing. And when you're stressed or anxious, and, you know, we're going to go into a second talking point in a second here, and it relates to this. It's a perfect seg. If you just go into nature and you observe and listen to the birds sing, and this is not woo for any of you guys that are listening to this, I think this is woo, and consciously choose to listen to them sing, they literally are so connected to your energy field that they will lower your stress by changing the frequency of their song. It's profound stuff. I've actually put it to test myself. You know, I read about this in one of the books that I was ripping through a couple of weeks ago. And, you know, I live in a pretty beautiful naturalesque setting now here in Tampa, Florida, in my backyard. And man, I can go out in the backyard with my dog, who's also my spiritual animal. He's a little blue-nosed pit bull. And the birds truly will change their frequency and their tonality. And if you're in it to listen to it and observe, you literally do, you know, it lowers the fight or flight, you know, you already said it, the activating system, to the point where you just automatically calm down. But so few people are really paying attention, you know, when they're actually out in nature and sitting there. But that was kind of mind blowing to me, because I was like, you know, I've been in that position so many times in my life, but I never really knew what was happening. But now I do. And so I have such a greater appreciation for it.
I experienced that on a whole nother level in Hawaii. You know, we talk about downshifting. It's like the time there were 5 hours, you know, difference from Austin. Yeah. And that actually served me really well, because I would wake up naturally to the alarm clock of the birds and the roosters. And they're basically singing, hey, here's your chance. Sunset's, you know, sun's going to rise in 15 minutes, you know, and that would motivate me. It was like, oh, thanks for this beautiful wake up call. And I would, you know, we're on the same block as the beach, and I would just walk down, catch the sunrise. And it was just the start of the best day ever. Yeah. And you're right. Nature is always sharing answers with us.
Yeah.
And so the more we can take time away from the Wi-Fi and the brain scramblers and all that and into nature, and just being present, remembering that we're a part of it all. Boy, I mean, look at an apple tree, you know, it's like, it just creates apples. It doesn't have to do anything. It's not, you know, there's not like, it's not on this fight or flight mode of trying to hurry anywhere, but everything gets done in perfect timing. And it's just creating apples. It doesn't care who's on Instagram that likes the apples or thinks that they're sour. You know, it's just creating as a creator. And with that tree analogy, you know, we'll take it a little further. You have a whole forest of trees. Mm-hmm. And nature's world wide web is the mycelium.
Right.
So they can communicate through this awesome network of fungi. And So if there's one tree that's ill or not getting enough resources and not growing, having some troubles, they communicate. The bigger trees can, you know, allocate those resources to that younger tree so that it can grow and get the nourishment that it needs to thrive like the rest of the forest.
Yes.
So knowing that it's all interconnected. And so humans have the same potential, the same opportunity. You know, it's not that Mother Nature doesn't provide enough for everyone. There's more than enough resources for every single living being, including animals, to thrive on Earth. It's not a matter of if there's enough. It's a matter of distributing it to where it's needed most. You know, we got some that are like greed, you know, just collect and collect and collect. It's never enough. And then others that are, you know, struggling in scarcity. And that's how nature's showing us how to balance that out, you know?
Yeah.
And so it's really beautiful example of, and with the surfer analogy, you know, when I first got into meditation, I was like, you're just supposed to clear your mind and stop your thoughts. Like, this feels impossible. Like, then you're thinking about not thinking thoughts, right? And, or don't think about a pink banana, right? And you're already thinking about it. So instead, it's like you said, just being an observer of it, you know, use your breath to slow things down. I imagine that I'm on a surfboard out past the breaker and I'm just watching my thoughts.
Yeah.
And all the thoughts are waves. And so I can just choose whichever wave I want to drop in on and surf with. And if I keep choosing negative waves, and how this would look as example would be like Charles 1.0 would be like, man, I'd look in the mirror in the morning and I had a program to always look for the faults. Like always look for the, oh, there's like, am I getting a wrinkle here or where there's another gray hair? Oh man. And then if I follow that thought, jump in on that wave, then there's a whole caveat of other negative waves that are like, oh man, I'm getting old. And then this increases cortisol in the body and worry is just praying for what we don't want. So instead it's like, oh, I see that thought. Like I acknowledge that and let it go. I'm not going to drop in on that wave. I can pull out and choose better thoughts. And this is recognizing the power of our attention and energy, where that goes is really what we're growing in our experience. And so I can choose a thought, a wave that feels like, you know, hey, gray hair looked great for Sean Connery. It's a shine of sophistication, wisdom, right? So that feels a little better in my body. I can ride that wave and then have more fun with it. And I like a little salt and pepper, you know? So that allows me to stay young. That's how my cells are responding, because I'm choosing thoughts, loving thoughts, compassionate thoughts that my body's responding all the time. And so I feel like I'm getting younger every year. And a lot of people are just so conditioned to the negative thoughts that keeps riding the same waves, getting the same experiences and the same uncomfortable emotions showing up in their experience. So there is a way out of that. And just watching from that seat of awareness and observing the thoughts instead of dropping in on every one of them. And you'll even be like, oh yeah, I used to go for that wave. I used to jump in that negative thought. And you just watch them go by, acknowledge them. It's a beautiful place to be. And from there you can choose wisely, you know, where is actually worthy of your attention and your energy.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful, man. Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of stuff you said there. I was going to say, like you said, you just watch the waves go by. I mean, all we are is waves. You know, we're literally vibrating particles and oscillating waves, hopefully are oscillating, of spiritual energy and are inhabiting these physical avatar bodies for, again, this purpose of soul evolution and growth at the end of the day. I mean, and, you know, where we place our consciousness, where our mind is all, but where we place our consciousness is what we get. Our thoughts truly do become things. Why would you ever think negatively? Like you were saying, like that worrying is, what was the word you said? Praying negatively? What was it?
Worrying is simply praying for what you don't want.
Praying for what you don't want, exactly.
You're giving it your energy, your attention.
And then you create it. I mean, think of how many people actually manifest exactly what they don't want. But, you know, from that perspective, and maybe this is a good conversation for people like you and me to have, it's still not a bad thing, right? Because if the purpose is evolution and growth of the soul, the greatest contrast provides the opportunity for the greatest growth. But it's up to you to choose to grow from it. And again, as you know, and I know, so many people stagnate. They attach to, you know, the lack or the scarcity or the limitation from their, and again, it's self-perceived of whatever it was, you know, a divorce, a death of a loved one, the loss of a job. I mean, a million things can be inserted in there, and then they're stuck.
Yeah.
Because you can't observe it from a place of like neutrality and say, how can I learn from this? Or how did this create this amazing opportunity for growth? And right. I think that's
we're
life.
We're the makers of it all. Right. Yeah. And so that's a great example. You know, something tragic like that happens, lose your job, lose your love, your life. And then you get into this place of feeling stuck, confusion. Now, that's pretty human.
Yeah.
To feel stuck sometimes, right? And to feel resistance is, but you don't have to stay there.
Right.
That's the good news. You know, there's a way through it where you can gain the lessons from that resistance, move forward. And, you know, for me, I'll give the example of anxiety, right? I feel like a lot of people can relate to this because it too is part of the human experience. And even that word can have a charge, like,
true.
It can feel like nails on a chalkboard for some people. It's like a constrictive nature. So if we break it down and just call it what it is, the A word is really energy, and you're dealing with a lot of energy moving through, right? It might be more cerebral. You can notice where it shows up in your body, and then using your breath to go into that a little bit more, because it's usually anxiety is avoidance and fear and not trusting in the process and flow of life. So right. When I got really good at avoiding this, like, you know, mediocre to low level anxiety and made sure that nobody could see it. But then I was out of congruence with what I was feeling inside versus what I was expressing outward. And so one day it kept getting worse. So I was like, you know what? I haven't tried yet. Instead of all these tactics to avoid anxiety, I'm just going to invite it in for tea. Right. Anxiety. And literally what I discovered was profound. It was like an old friend had been knocking on the door and had an important message for me. And I had just been avoiding answering the door. And so when I finally let it in and went deeper into that energy, it showed me right smack in my face, my biggest fear, you know, and this was a fear that supersedes all the fear of rejection, looking stupid, public speaking, all this stuff. This was a fear that became a catalyst for me because I recognized I'd been so close to death and lost, you know, some of the people I love most, my parents. And so that's given me a very rich experience of life and how temporary this human experience is. And in that, I was able to dive into this larger fear, which was deathbed regrets.
You know, that's awesome.
Knowing that, man, someday I'm going to leave this body, and did I play full out? You know, did I take these ideas, these messages on my heart that could potentially help a lot of people to the grave because I was in fear and playing small? That eats me up inside. So recognizing that, it was a catalyst. It was like a healthy fear.
Yeah.
Man, why have I been avoiding this so much? This is an old friend trying to share some important information. So that inspired me to create more programs. That's what inspired the laser focus method that I created that helps people go from over-consuming and addictive behaviors into stepping into creator consciousness and as a side effect, making more money and supporting your family and all the great things and gamifying your get-to-do lists instead of letting that be more stress that's added and put you into fight or flight. So that was a game changer. And I never looked at anxiety the same. I never experienced it the same after that. Now it's like a little knock at the door. Yeah. And it's like, oh, thank you. Of course, I've been consuming more than I've been creating lately. So of course, I'm getting that feeling of anxiety showing up again. But it's not as scary anymore. It's like an important friend sharing a message. So that encouraged me to go deeper into all the heavy emotions that I'd been avoiding, you know, and discover the gold there. And so that's been a lot of my work, is helping people extract those lessons and blessings from the most challenging, uncomfortable things that we often avoid. There's so much gold there, you know? And so it's been a beautiful self-discovery journey that opens up a lot of dreams coming true. When we're willing to go into the source of our triggers, you know, the things that really like fire us up, get us angry, or spark up some grief or frustration, whatever that is, we've been taught to avoid it. Go to the fridge, stuff it, you know, go on Netflix, escape from it.
Right.
Well, if you go into that, and I teach a step-by-step process to reparenting the younger version of you that was going through that for the first time, because you think about, you know, being scared or the feeling of grief now as adults, we're like, yeah, we're familiar with it at least. You know, it's not fun, but as a child, for the first time experiencing this, this is very intense and a novel experience. And we create decisions that we make about ourselves then.
Right.
These become the limiting beliefs that keep showing up in our experience that will block us from the next level of abundance, success, the relationship, you know, turmoils. This stuff will keep showing up until we go to the source of it. And so in my opinion, one of the greatest skills to have, you know, as an evolving human is the ability to go into and heal these childhood traumas and make peace with that past. It's like rescuing that part of us. So now, you know, the little 5-year-old Charles is back online, and now I have that level of imagination and inspiration for life, you know, on board. And I got to identify those negative beliefs and then embody a deeper truth by connecting through to my higher self in that process. And this has been such a game changer for me. This helped me heal the abandonment wound. This helped me call in my queen and, you know, allowed a lot of dreams to come true really fast after doing this inner work. And this is why I keep taking this medicine anytime I get triggered, because it's not only healing it for myself, but also for my girls, you know, my children and future generations. Now they don't have to carry forth this negative belief pattern that's been carried down, these generational wounds,
yeah, generational traumas
down. Right. So that's exciting. You know, the more I can keep going into the source of it, heal it for myself, I feel like that's the greatest thing we can do for the world. Everybody wants to go out and change the world. How about going in and healing what's not in alignment with you anymore? And amazing. Pulling those weeds of limiting beliefs, like weeds in the garden, planting deeper truths that it's remembering, you know, what is true, that we're incredible, eternal creators. And what an opportunity here in Contrastville to get to experience light and dark, good and evil, for the most learning to really know thyself. So it's quite a treat.
Are you using therapeutic peptides? Are you a new user, maybe an advanced user? Maybe you're considering starting peptides. Highly recommend going to the link right below, thepeptidescourse.com/10-mistakes, and download my PDF and learn what not to do before starting therapeutic peptides. It's amazing, man. I mean, I say this, you know, to the people in my inner circle and some people that I work with and stuff too. It's even in my upcoming book. I put a long, it's like 6 or 7 paragraphs at the very beginning of the book. And it's a book on fat loss. You know, it's a scientific treatise on fat loss and using peptides and all the things that I'm, you know, quote unquote expert on. And I put in there at the very beginning that if you don't love and trust yourself, It doesn't matter what tools, right, what tips, what tricks, what tactics. So, you know, you were just saying the same exact thing. I mean, that's the number one thing you can do for yourself is literally to learn to love and trust yourself unconditionally, and then to project or take that sense of awareness and that state of being into the ether and with every single person that you meet, you know, because as you know, your energy of love and trust, you know, instantly raises the field and the vibrational frequency of all the people that you come into contact with. I mean, you know, how many times in your life, I mean, you're this guy, I'm this guy now, and we know it because this is what we do, but like how many times in your life when you weren't where you are now and where I wasn't where I was now, where you would meet, you know, probably each of us have met five or six of these people, maybe more, these magnanimous people, right? Like you would come into a room and they were so energizing and they were such, they were beacons of light.
Yeah.
And you just would like look at them and just be in awe. And as you know too, Charles, like the opposite is true, right? There's energy vampires. Mm-hmm. There's parasitics, right? So it's like, it's amazing when you truly do love and trust yourself, how that helps the collective, because you're carrying that frequency everywhere you go. And, you know, as the great Dr. Hawkins has taught people or taught us or taught me, you know, you have the ability to transmute lower frequencies and lower energy fields just by maintaining a higher frequency. So it's like, that is the key, is literally, as you said, you know, if you want to change the world, change yourself. I mean, you literally must become unconditionally in full love and trust of yourself.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. And there's extremes to everything, right? There's the camp that's all about good vibes only and, you know, high vibe, ultra spiritual. That's like, sure. No. don't even look at negativity or don't even give it, you know, that's fine. But there's oftentimes a lot of bypassing going on in that camp. And until, you know, these things keep getting triggered over and over until we go to the source of it to heal it.
Right, exactly right.
And that's what's great, because it expands our capacity for the whole emotional spectrum in the human experience, right? There was a time when I wasn't willing to go into the depths of grief. You know, it was scary. I would just could seek pleasure, sex, drugs, rock and roll instead. But that put a cap on how much joy I could experience, sure, and how much bliss and pleasure. But as soon as I went to the depths of those heavy emotions, then it became temporary. You know, it actually dissolves in that way. Whereas if we're just trying to resist it because it doesn't feel good, it just stays stuck as issues. It'll show up as pain. Yep. It'll show up as, you know, internal conflict. And that shows up externally in being short, being, you know, kind of spiteful or resentful to our loved ones. You know, these emotions are like a volcano. You know, everybody has their boiling point. And when those spill over unconsciously, it's usually on the ones we love the most.
That's right.
And so when we take care of that and take responsibility for our own energy, our emotions, and those, you know, trapped emotions, and have a process for resolving those, it frees up so much energy. And then you're feeling the same energy that creates planets flowing to and through you. And I can't keep all this in one body. Like, I got to share it. And that's the inspiring action that's like, you know, creates the book, that creates the message, the TED Talks, the, you know, the exciting things. And so, you know, I can give an example. Back in the day when I was in Sweden visiting a dear friend for midsummer, brought my brother there, and we are just in heaven. I mean, there's a waterfall coming down. His mom had made us this like gazpacho and these incredible gluten-free, you know, picnic that we're having in paradise. And then we jump off these cliffs into ice cold water, cold plunge. And we're just sitting back, laying on this bedrock, absorbing the sun, and just this peak state of just natural euphoria. And I connected with my higher self. And it was like, this feels so good, you can't keep it to yourself. And it was like, you're meant to share this. And that's when I made a deal with my higher self. I said, you're right, I will get published this year and write a book, you know. And I don't consider myself a great writer. I don't, you know, so as soon as I declared that, all the mental egoic thoughts, you know, the waves started coming of like, you're not a great writer. How are you going to get it published? Who's going to even read this?
Nobody cares.
I let all those go by and just came back to, I'm open to all possibilities for this book being written in the easiest, most graceful way. And literally a week after I returned from that trip, that vacation vibration that I was experiencing, I took it into my daily life and into my business. And I got a message from a guy, Tyler Wagner, who owns Authors United. You know, it's a publishing company. And he reached out and said, you know, you came highly recommended. We'd love to have you as a co-author in our book, on our new project. Would you be interested?
There it is, universe.
So that's what happens when we get out of our own way, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
Give our energy to those thoughts, the self-doubt. And so that, of course, you know, one of my chapters in the book was, you know, vacation vibration. How do we integrate that into your daily life and to gamify things so that you're self-sourcing more instead of needing to feel good from something externally? Because that pharmacy is within you already, you know, the oxytocin, serotonin, dopamine. So creating intrinsic reward systems is a system I developed that helps people release their addictions and heal the source of their vices and these addictions that have been, you know, keeping them stuck for a long time. And
I want to talk about both of those if you don't mind, but I want to go back to something you said, and I want, you know, you can agree or disagree. I mean, I know you agree, but the planet right now is really exactly what you've been saying, but said in another way, you're either empowered, sovereign, and free, fully personally accountable, or you're not. And, you know, call those people living in the victimhood frequency.
Yep.
And anyone can right now with a thought, you know, the Neville Goddard, the wishes fulfilled, claim full empowerment, full sovereignty, full abundance, full prosperity, however they want to look at the most positive frequency. But so many people choose, as you call it, the external, the external savior. You know, there's somebody or something out there that is going to grant them, you know, sovereignty or saviorhood or whatever, saving them, however you want to look at it. And it's interesting because you and I, we all go through that, right? Like as a human incarnated in a physical body, you have to pass through that level. Right. And as you also know, you know, you were talking about, you know, good and evil, fear. I mean, it's here, these duality, these reverse polarity energies are here for us to evolve through them. Right. So it's like when you start realizing that they're actually there to help you,
right,
and not to harm you, and not to be, like you said, in resistance or afraid of it. And again, everything goes back to fear. And I like to say that the real fear is the lack of finite experience, which is death. Right. And when you get to a spiritual level of awareness of death is just the end of the physical avatar and not the end of the energy of your soul, there is no fear. But I mean, you got to get there. And unfortunately, in this third dimensional experience, there's so many, call it the control structure or the paradigm of common thought, the narrative teaches people about limitation, lack, and scarcity.
Right.
And they want them to think that death is the end. You know, I always think of Lord of the Rings. When one of the little hobbits is speaking to Gandalf and, you know, he's afraid, you know, it's the battle of Mithilorian or whatever at the top of the, they're sitting at the top of the bastions, you know, and the hobgoblins are swarming in and he's like, but Gandalf, are we going to die? And Gandalf says, no, Merry, death is not the end. It's the beginning of the next path, mm-hmm. one that we all must take. Right. So it's like, it's so profound to like get to that level of awareness. And as you know, Hollywood is constantly seeding consciousness with negative, dark and light. And it's your choice to where you place your consciousness. And, you know, in a movie like that, there's so much positivity and light, just as there's an equal amount of duality and negativity and obviously other movies and stuff like that. But it's so interesting that when you do get to that place of sovereignty, and again, I really think that that's the journey in the third dimension. The journey is to get the sovereignty and then hopefully to serve, you know, at your highest and best, like you're doing, like I'm doing, help as many people as we possibly can. And then, you know, in a perfect world, Charles, graduate, you know, to wherever it is we're going to graduate. And maybe graduation is just coming back again with this awareness level to help more people attain this awareness level.
Right.
We don't know.
Yeah. I call it sovereign chi.
Sovereign chi.
You know, it's like chi, your life force energy. And there's even a guided practice, you know, on my website. All the listeners can get it for free.
Awesome.
Clay.coach. Try it out for yourself. I'm all about experiential learning.
Yeah.
So it's a meditation, movement, and breathwork practice. It's a game changer for filling up with your own life force energy, you know, so that you can just return to sender. Anything that's not yours that you picked up that you've been, you know, carrying, that's like, I call it 3D debris, you know, weighing.
I love that, man. You got a lot of conscious terms, man. 3D debris. Somebody design a logo for you like that with 3D debris? Do you have that?
And I should, yeah. So
I have somebody I can connect you with that can design something really cool like that, because that's what he does. But that's awesome, dude. I love that. 3D debris.
It's releasing the weight. You know, we often get so used to everything that we're carrying that, like, having a ritual and a practice that you can go to actually ground and return to sender and release what's not yours and then fill up again with your own life force energy, it is a game changer. And then you create from that space, that life becomes really exciting and more exciting than any movie you're going to find on Netflix.
Totally, man.
Totally. And that's the creator consciousness. That's what, you know, we're here to share our unique God-given gifts. You bring a medicine frequency that's unique and different than anybody else on this entire planet. And there's a lot of people that need that, you know, that, like, we're all puzzle pieces to this giant picture. And, you know, if we play small, then eventually we'll get to the end of this human experience and look back, you know. And, you know, I've interviewed a lot of people that have had near-death experiences, that have died and came back, that have, you know, been on their deathbed. And there's a common denominator, two things. They see a light, you know, they can head towards. And the second one is they get a review of their life.
Yeah, life review.
So the DMT is released and it goes in, you know, reverse order all the way to when you were born. And I am going to die happy. I'm going to go, I'm playing all out. I get to dance through fear. You know, I realize that fear is here as resistance, as the darkness to show us how much light we can actually generate. And so I appreciate that contrast because it allows for the greatest learning. Mm-hmm. And, you know, to die happy means sharing your God-given gifts to the path of highest fulfillment, you know, to impacting, you know, people's lives as much as you can, with your messages on your heart. Why play small and get to the end of your life and wish, man, I wish I would have shared that, or the cojones to do that talk, or, you know, share that program. It could have helped so many people. So I've looked closely at that, and that's my inspiration. You know, that's how fear has helped me. And that's inspiring because a lot of people can dance through fear and create more than they're consuming. And then they're sharing their God-given gifts and impacting others in a big way. And that's when a lot of dreams come true.
Right.
You know, and that's when you get to experience the, you know, millionairehood and the cool things and your soulmate and, you know, having kids, the white picket fence, if that's your dream, what, you know, whatever it is for you, those dreams are on the other side of the 3D debris, of the fears that you're avoiding. You know, and so it is so exciting to get to do this work because I get to witness a lot of amazing dreams coming true. And it's not always easy, but it's always worth it going into the source of the 3D debris, the resistance, the fear, whatever, you know, emotions are trapped that we haven't been allowing ourselves to feel. And that's why I'm here, to help more dreams come true in this physical realm. And what a fun job. It's like a dream come true in itself. You know, here we are, a dream within a dream.
That's exactly right. The dream of the mass consciousness of collective, you have a choice. You know, you can be in resonance or dissonance. You get to choose every single waking moment. You know, it's a, you know, like you were saying earlier in the morning, just going to a sunrise. I mean, my wife and I did that when we were living in Playa del Carmen at least 5 days a week. You know, we were the same thing. We were literally like 40 to 50 yards, depending on where the surf was. Mm-hmm. You know, and it was just unreal to just wake up every morning and just be birthed and bathed by the morning light of the sun. You know, talk about source.
Yeah.
You know, that's really
a spiritual experience every day. And to wake up to that, boy, that's some great energy you're cultivating and communing with to start your day. You know, I feel like religion is, all the different religions are just simply trying to explain the same thing, you know, and spirituality is basically, you know, not just being an idiot and taking actions that result in negative consequences and then hoping that God will come save you.
Right.
You know, it's about taking responsibility and being a co-creator in this exciting journey together. And when you choose that path, then it's like you realize, wow, universe, God, source, creator, whatever you want to call it, has your back.
Yeah.
It's like the universe wants to experience your dreams through you too, you know? And so it's conspiring to help us. And so we already have the greatest management team that we can access with more practice, you know? So it's a very exciting journey.
I mean, it's been a beautiful podcast, man. You actually have an offer. So you guys got to be follow him on IG. I don't even know. I'm such a social media idiot. Give him a follow on IG. I think that's what it means. But you actually have a free gift for people that will follow you, right? You want to talk about that?
Yeah. So join me on IG if you're on there, charlesclay.coach, and shoot me a DM if you want to dive deep, gain one of the best self-healing tools to resolve, you know, the source of suffering and allow more dreams to come true. Just, you know, message me IPP, inner peace process. And I'm happy to offer a 15-minute support call to see where you're at, where you want to go, help you gain some clarity on that path as long as, you know, I still have space available. And then make sure you get that free gift to experience sovereignty, like home base. And that's on my website, charlesclay.coach. Just subscribe at the bottom to experience that for yourself. And that's an amazing good morning ritual or a practice you can use anytime your energy is feeling off.
Bro, amazing podcast, man. I'm really grateful to actually converse with you, communicate with you, connect with you. I honestly did not know you today before this podcast today, but I want to know more about you. So that's the amazing aspect now of technology, right? Because as we were talking in this, you know, you can utilize it for amazing things or you can consume too much of it. Right. And never create anything. But, you know, clearly the choices always are. So, man, I really, truly do appreciate you coming on here today. So, guys and gals, all the amazing folks that watch the Jay Campbell podcast, please support Charles. Go and follow him on IG at charlesclay.coach. Check out his website also, which is charlesclay.coach, www, of course, charlesclay.coach. And also visit him, what was the thing you're for the subscribe again for the sovereign G?
Charlesclay.coach, just subscribe at the bottom. You'll get an auto email with that guided alignment activation. So you can experience that for yourself. And it's a game changer, man. This has been a lot of fun, Jay. Appreciate you and all that you do and are, and look forward to more.
Thanks, my brother. Remember, guys and gals, raise your vibration to optimize your love creation. We will see all of you guys very soon.